there are many human beings, or most of the religions besides Islam, they have the concept of anthropomorphism. Most of the religions besides Islam have the concept of anthropomorphism. Anthropomorphism means Almighty God taking forms. And most of the religions besides Islam, they believe Almighty God took human form once, while other religions believe he took many times. And they have a very good philosophy that Almighty God, he's so holy, he's so pure. He does not know the shortcomings of the human beings. He does not know how does the human being feel when he's hurt. He does not know how does the human being feel when he's troubled. So therefore, Almighty God, being so holy and pure, he became a human being and came in this world to know what is good or what is bad for the human being so that he could lay down the rules for the human beings. On the face of it, it sounds like a very good logic. Almighty God, so holy, so pure, so pious. He does not know the shortcomings of the human being. How does the human being feel when he's hurt, when he's in trouble, when he's in pain? So he came on this earth, he became a human being to know what is good or what is bad for the human being. I tell these people that suppose I manufacture a DVD player. Do I have to become a DVD player to know what is good or what is bad for the DVD player? What do? I write an instruction manual that if you want to play the DVD, insert the DVD and press the play button. If you want to stop, press the stop button. If you want to skip, press the skip button. Don't drop it from a height, it will get damaged. Don't immerse it in water, it will get spoiled. I write an instruction manual. I don't have to become a DVD player to know what is good or what is bad for the DVD player. Similarly, Almighty God is the creator of the human beings. He does not have to become a human being to know what is good or what is bad for the human being. What does he do? He reveals the instruction manual. And the last and final instruction manual for the human beings, it's the glorious Quran. This glorious Quran is the last and final instruction manual for the human beings. The do's and don'ts, what is good, what is bad for the human beings, is given in this last and final instruction manual, the glorious Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not have to come down himself to write the instruction manual. What does he do? He chooses a man amongst the men and communicates with them on a higher level, who we call as messengers of Almighty God. And he reveals the message. So if you understand the concept of God, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Islam, you will understand Islam in the right perspective. So to understand the concept of God in various religions, you have to read the scripture of that religion so that you understand religion in the right perspective.